Hello everyone, welcome to the next session of Alfonso School's e-learning classes. I, Sangeeta Oak, am here to refine your grammar skills. Today, through this session, we will be learning about degrees of comparison. You all are familiar with them. You all know there are 3 degrees of comparison: the positive degree, the comparative degree, and the superlative degree, right? Now, in the positive degree, we use these adjectives in its simple form. For example, Ravi is a smart boy. Now, another thing which we need to understand in the positive degree is that it is used to describe just one thing, right? For example, we just use the word smart to describe how Ravi is. In the comparative degree, we see that the comparative degree is used to describe 2 things. Over here in the example, we see Ravi is smarter than Amit. That means Ravi is described or compared with Amit using the word smarter. In the superlative degree, the superlative degree is used to describe more than one things in the same group or in the same class. For example, we see Ravi is one of the smartest boy in the class. So we are comparing Ravi with many other boys in the class. Similarly, another rule or another syntax that we need to understand in the degrees of comparison is the adjective changes depending on if it is a regular adjective or if it is an irregular adjective. For example, over here we see that whenever we write for the regular adjectives in the positive degree, right, we write as plus the adjective plus as. For example, here we see before the adjective smart, we use the word as well as after the adjective smart, we use the word as, right? So we say that Ravi is as smart as Amit. We are describing Ravi. In the next comparative degree, we use the adjective and we add er to the adjective. Plus, we add the word than, which is the most important thing. So over here, in the comparative degree, we say Ravi is smarter than Amit. Over here, if you see, we are adding er to the adjective smart and we are adding the word than. In the superlative degree, right, the syntax used for the superlative degree is the plus the adjective plus we add est. So in the example, we have used the example stating that Ravi is the smartest boy in the class. So we are using the and we are adding est to the adjective smart. Now, this was for all the regular adjectives, right? Another example of a regular adjective we can say is that Kiran is a clever boy, right? In the comparative degree, it becomes clever, becomes cleverer. We add er to the word or to the adjective clever. Similarly, in the superlative degree, we add or we say Ravi is the cleverest boy in the class. So we add est to the word clever. Now these are just the examples of regular adjectives where the adjective remains the same. We just add er in the comparative and est in the superlative degree. Now for the irregular adjectives, there is no change in the positive degree, it remains the same as it is. For example, Renu is a beautiful girl. Now over here, before the word beautiful or after the word beautiful also, if we are comparing Renu with some other girl, we can say Renu is as beautiful as Smita or some other girl, right? Then in the comparative degree, if you see, we add more to the adjective, right? And as usual, we add the word than, because beautiful cannot become beautifuler. Beautiful becomes more beautiful. It is said to be an irregular adjective. So we see Renu is more beautiful than Sapna. In the superlative degree, what do? We add the word most before the adjective. So we see Renu is the most beautiful girl in the class, right? So over here, we see beautiful becomes more beautiful, and in the superlative, beautiful becomes most beautiful, right? So similarly, another example of an irregular adjective can be when we use the word or when we use the adjective intelligent. We say intelligent, more intelligent, and most intelligent. So I hope with this session, you are able to understand how you can identify the positive, the comparative, and the superlative degree. Thank you.